What did I say to you?
Thank you.
Mr. Gowell, as senior class president, it is my honor to present you the graduating class of 2018.
Everyone, please remain standing as we pay honor to our country with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. We will now sing our national anthem.
One of the counselors at Berkley High School, and I am here to introduce class salutatorian Gabrielle Fieber. I have a couple quick things to say about her. Gabrielle, why don't you come walk around so you are ready to take the mic. Finish times in cross-country races. Finish times in cross-country races are often like the race between valedictorian and salutatorian. 1/10 of a second or 1/10 of a point separates first from second place. It is not without irony that Gabrielle Fieber is holder of both class of 2018 salutatorian and also, according to her cross-country coach, holder of the best 5K time at Berkley High School since the turn of the century. Gabrielle Fieber's mile time is as low as her GPA is high. She is a young woman of fierce independence, determination, and focus. And as our beloved Woody in Toy Story once said, only with a small revision in word choice, run like the wind, Bullseye. Straight to Michigan Tech with all of your intelligence, passion, and purpose, and never look back. Congratulations. Welcome, students, teachers, and families. I am honored to have been a part of Berkley High School's class of 2018 for the last 4 years. First off, I would like to thank the administrators and teachers for guiding us on our journey throughout high school. We have all grown quite a bit since freshman year, and it is thanks to all of your wisdom. Before I continue, I would like you all to take a second to look around. Notice the abundance of people surrounding you. Feel the warm, calm air. Listen to the leaves rustling in the wind. For the remainder of tonight, allow yourself to only focus on what is going on around you, not the meeting you have tomorrow or all the things you still need to do by the end of the week, but just allow yourself to be in the present moment. While I have learned many things throughout high school, there is one main lesson I learned that has really impacted my life: to live in the moment. This lesson became prominent to me recently after constantly being asked questions such as, where are you going to college? What do you want to do with your life? How do you not know what your major is yet? After being asked these questions, I realized one important thing. We constantly look towards the future. We don't want to focus on here and now, and in a way, this inhibits us. In one of my teacher's rooms, there's a poster that has continually caught my eye. It talks about the iceberg illusion. This illusion talks about what people see versus what people don't see when it comes to success. Like the tip of an iceberg, only someone's success is seen, and not the steps taken to achieve it. While the point of the poster is to show that it takes hard work to achieve success, and before becoming successful, people fail many times, when I look at the poster, I think about how people only strive for the tip without allowing themselves to experience the entire journey. Being here today, graduating, this is the tip of the iceberg. While graduation is a big deal, there's so much more to high school, such as my ninth grade field trip to Mayberry State Park, the different sporting events, even the SAT. I will always remember the memories I made during each of these experiences, good and bad. It's small moments like these, moments under the water that we will always remember and that have impacted our life much more than commemorating our successes. Instead of living for the future, we should focus on the present moment, here and now. Here and now, the class of 2018 is graduating. Who we will become and what we will do with our lives is unknown. All we need to focus on right now is being proud that we made it, through the happiness, the sadness, and everything in between. We experienced this journey together, and we have all grown from our experiences. As you all continue on your journey, I wish you good luck. I know you will all do amazing things with your life and have many successes. As you go along, though, never forget that your quest for success is just as important, if not more important, than the success itself. Don't just strive for the tip, but take the dip in the water as well. Thank you.
Please stand as the class of 2018 invites you to sing the Berkley High School alma mater. Now, I am pleased to introduce Superintendent Mr. Dennis McDavid. Ladies and gentlemen,
parents, guardians, grandparents, siblings, guests, colleagues, and graduates. It's my honor to welcome you this evening. As I begin, I want to take a moment to introduce and thank our school board for all of their hard work. Our school board sets the tone of high expectations for the whole district. Our board is one of just a handful of boards out of the nearly 600 boards in the state to have earned the prestigious Standard of Excellence designation. I'd like to introduce each of them and ask them to stand. Please hold your applause until all seven have been introduced. Our trustees are Roger Blake, Mike Tripp, Keith Logden. Our officers are Treasurer Mitchell Moses, Secretary Ron Justice, Vice President Cheryl Stoddard, and President Mary Jo Israel. Thank you. I'd also like to introduce our central office team. This group of people works behind the scenes, and they are intently focused on helping our building administrators and teachers create the conditions needed for our children to succeed. Again, please hold your applause until all are introduced. Our team is Deputy Superintendent Larry Gallagher, Director of Schools and Human Resources,
Chris Sandoval, Director of Student Services, Heather Lackey, Director of Curriculum, Technology, Assessments, and Grants, Scott Francis, and our Communications Supervisor, Jessica Stilger. Thank you. Incidentally, this year, Mr. Gallagher earned the distinction as the Oakland County School Business Executive of the Year. It's a well-deserved honor and one which reflects his dedicated service to our district and our students. Congratulations, Mr. Gallagher. I'd also like to acknowledge Principal Randy Gall and his team of administrators, teachers, counselors, secretaries, and support staff. I want to make a special mention of Ms. Sandvit and Ms. Flood, our senior class sponsors. They've done another great job this year. Thanks to all of you. Now to the class of 2018. You've been a remarkable class. While at Berkley High School, nearly 68% of you took at least one advanced placement class. That's a college level class. 68% is an astounding number when you consider nationwide, only 12% of high school students will graduate this year with one AP class. 18% of the class took rigorous vocational education classes, and over 25 of you earned certifications in everything from computer programming to auto mechanics to nurse apprenticeships. 4 of you earned apprenticeship status in the construction trades. Nearly 30% of the class was in band, orchestra, or choir. Over 100 students participated in drama. 40% of you distinguished yourselves on the athletic fields. Over 85% of you have applied to at least one college to continue your studies next year. 4 of you will begin serving the country immediately as you enter the United States Army, Navy, Coast Guards, or Marines. In an increasingly competitive college application process, 72% of those who applied to Michigan State were accepted, and 43% of those applying to the University of Michigan were accepted there. Yeah, those are fantastic numbers. You and your classmates have earned well over $3 million in scholarship money, with students earning full tuition to colleges such as Wayne State, Eastern Michigan, Central Michigan, the University of Alabama, Michigan State, the University of Michigan, and Kalamazoo College. Others of you were accepted at and or will be attending the University of Alaska, American College of Greece, American University of Paris, Barnard College, Boston University, Case Western Reserve, the University of Chicago, Dartmouth College, Emory University, Florida Gulf Coast University, the University of Florida, the University of Hawaii, Howard University, McGill University, Tufts University, and Tulane. Many of you who are included in the numbers I just mentioned and the places I just mentioned. Many of you are included in those, and many are not in this graduating class. Some of you struggled through high school with your issues not always known to others. You may have had a learning disability or a cognitive issue or family challenges which made the work harder and the struggle real. Your effort and successes and the perspectives you bring ennoble and enrich us. I want all of you to know that we are just as proud of you as we are of any of our graduates tonight. For all of you, I have no doubt that wherever you go or whatever you do, you'll be successful. Maybe not in your first or second attempt, but if you persist in following your dreams, if you accept that at times you will need to course correct, and if you understand that along the way you'll make mistakes, both big and small, you'll be successful. One of the great joys in my job is visiting classrooms in all of our schools across the district. In the winter, I was at Pattengill Elementary, and a kindergarten class was in the hallway preparing for recess. Students were sitting on the floor, putting on boots, and standing up, pulling on coats and mittens in a hurried, frenzied chaos to get outside for recess. I noticed one little boy standing there, and his shoes were untied. I pointed that out to him and asked if he could tie his shoes. "I'm still learning," he said. "Do you want me to help you?" I asked. "Yes, please," he said. Our students are always so polite. So I kneeled down and tied one shoe, and then without a word, he stuck his other foot out, and I tied that shoe as well. I was feeling good about this little act of kindness when I noticed that his teacher had been watching me the whole time. "Thanks for your help, Mr. McDavid," she said. "Oh, I'm glad to help out any way I can," I said, still feeling good about the example I had set. "Did you happen to notice," she said, "that his shoes are on the wrong feet?" I felt my face turn a little red, and then she said to me, "I'm so glad that we have you running our district." And then we both laughed about it. And I'm telling you tonight because I'm a glutton for punishment, but I tell you this story first because it's true. It actually happened. Second, it illustrates the point that we'll make mistakes, big and small, along the way, even when we're just trying to help. And we will need to be able to laugh at ourselves. And thirdly, it points out the need to serve and be kind to others. There's an old Chinese proverb that says, if you want happiness for an hour, take a nap. If you want happiness for a day, go fishing. If you want happiness for a year, inherit a fortune. And if you want happiness for a lifetime, help someone. Leo Tolstoy said, the sole meaning of life is to serve humanity. Winston Churchill said, we make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give. So some of the best thinkers the world has ever produced have come to the conclusion that service to others is the highest value. I think that in the world we live in today, it's important to remember that service and not celebrity, service and not slanderous insults, and service and not super material riches are what we should aspire to. Graduates, in your lives, you have been given marvelous examples of service. Your parents, your families, and your friends have served you in innumerable ways that have helped you grow and mature. 13 years ago, when you came to us as little children, your teachers and administrators and school staff served you by opening milk cartons and wiping noses, giving hugs and teaching you to read and write and add and subtract and challenging and supporting and encouraging you. For the past 13 years, you've matured into young men and young women. You've witnessed acts of service and kindness as your teachers and staff have given untold hours to help you learn and grow. In a very real sense, your teachers have sacrificed a great deal of their lives to enrich your lives. Our community, by supporting our schools through our bond initiatives and through the support they give to all of our fundraisers, athletic and artistic events, is also a model of service that works. And graduates, you yourselves have been models of service for all of us and for each other, as you have volunteered for things like caring and sharing, to be a tutor or a peer mentor, or to raise money for a just cause, or as a counselor to our fifth graders at camp, or by giving blood, or in any number of other ways. In this district and in this community, and I think indeed in this country, Serving others is a core virtue, and it helps define who we are. So as you go through life, remember the virtue that helping others is. Remember that you'll never stand taller than when you stoop to help someone else. And remember that whatever you do and wherever you go, there is a group of people in this district who believe in you, who love you, and who are supporting you in all that you do. Congratulations to each of you. You'll be great. President Israel, members of the board, graduates, colleagues, families, and friends, we have a rare privilege tonight. As you know, Mr. Gal is leaving us after more than 8 years of service to Berkley High School and her students. Mr. Gal has been a model of selfless giving and has done so much to support and uplift our students in all that he's done. So tonight, our first diploma, a Berkley High School honorary diploma, is being awarded to Randall Powell Gal for all that he has done for our students. Please join me in congratulating Mr. Gal.
Every year, the members of the senior class have a chance to compete for the opportunity to speak at graduation, leaving the senior class, as well as family and friends, with a few parting thoughts.
This is a fun and creative way to wrap up our time here at BHS. Please welcome this year's senior speech contest winner, my girl, Taylor Favors. Good evening, everyone. Have you ever heard sayings or quotes about how your life is just one big book? Well, I don't agree with that. I feel as if life has a series of books, and each book has a certain period of time that is focused on from beginning to end. Right now, I will be talking about the book of high school and how today is the day where this book ends. Your book probably starts your freshman year. We were all so young, nervous, and excited to enter high school. We did not know what to expect in the next 4 years of our lives, but we assumed we were ready. Come to find out, it was nothing like we had expected. From being annoying freshmen to dealing with them, the lit football games, going from Obama to Trump, no comment on that, and realizing that sophomore, junior, and senioritis is real was unpredictable. Now we are the graduating class of 2018. This is the final chapter of many more. We got through Powder Puff, the police showing up every 5 seconds, the questionable outcome of the Senior Bear Awards, and realizing that some people don't know what the word hygiene means. All jokes aside, our books could not have been written without the people around us at Berkley High School. We may not notice it at times, but we all helped each other grow into who we are today. In your book, you probably include those friends that stuck by you no matter what, or how Victor would magically appear out of thin air telling you to take your hat off. Although all our books are written in different perspectives, we all are ending this book of high school here. Everyone has an important role in this book and the next. Our friends, families, counselors, teachers, and administrators all help prepare us for the next part of our lives. The mock interviews, parental advice, and the daily meetings with our counselor will all be useful as we begin our journey. Whether you are going to a four-year college or university, trade school, community college, work, or the armed forces, I wish you the best of luck. Berkley has worked hard to prepare us for the world that's out there, and now it is time for us to experience it on our own. Now everybody, take out your pens and pencils and begin writing this new book of many more to come. Congratulations, class of 2018, the end.
Thank you. Good evening. It is my honor to introduce the class of 2018's valedictorian, Andrew Schildkraut. This year's valedictorian is one who I cannot contain my appreciation and admiration for. He lives his life to do good, and it pays back in happiness. Next year, he will be attending the University of Chicago, where he will be studying the history, philosophy, and social studies of science and medicine. Andrew has made a lasting impression on his teachers, teammates, and peers, and his infectious smile will be greatly missed.
Thank you, Mrs. Tai, for your kind introduction, and thank you to all the Berkley teachers and staff, friends, family, and community members that have supported us these past many years and continue to support us tonight as we start this next book in our series. I've got to be honest. This robe is kind of uncomfortable. This hat as well. It's scratchy, a little too warm, and is 100% a crime against fashion. But nonetheless, it is a staple of graduations, and following that tradition, here we are. So last week, my curiosity led me to do a very quick Google search to try and figure out why we have to wear these less than ideal garments. I learned that robes were first worn during graduations to mimic the clergy, as 12th and 13th century learning institutions were almost all religious. Also, the thick robes and hoods were quite useful in medieval buildings without gas-burning furnaces. So since none of that applies right now, why do we still wear these? Since I wasn't able to find a good reason in 5 minutes of scouring the internet, I figured I would make up a few of my own. First, I propose that these robes, and their uniformity, serve as a reminder of the leveling effect of education. With our passions nurtured, curiosity cultivated, and with the tools to empower ourselves, we are better able to fight for our right to be equals in society, in that we are able to fully appreciate all that humanity has created and discovered, and all that we have yet to improve in our world. This isn't just a one-time deal, however, as we can then turn around and work to give that opportunity to those who don't have the means to empower themselves. As these robes remind us of that ideal, of education, justice, and empowerment, they should also prompt us to think of the disconnect between that ideal and reality. They should remind us that as we celebrate all that we have accomplished up until today, and as we look towards the future, that we remember not only those who don't have access to this great opportunity, but those among us who weren't able to glean as much from our country's education system as others. I'm grateful that we were part of an institution, Berkley Schools, that recognizes the potential in everyone and does everything it can to help every student realize that potential for themselves. As we move forward, this fight for justice should not be thought of as only the child of politics and protest. Although these may be means to an end, true justice is the inevitable flowering of the seeds of kindness, compassion, and a deeply rooted respect for our fellow human beings. We should strive to create change not only as political entities, nor as followers of movements, but as leaders for those closest to us, showing our love for our fellow humans by following our own passions to make a unique mark upon the world. For through education, through equality, through compassion, these robes may one day stand to reflect the reality of our education system, not just of its ideals. Second, I propose that these robes are the dress code's latest attempt to keep our shoulders covered up. Either that, or our parents' last attempt to put us in a bib. And third, I propose that these robes demonstrate that as we go forth in the world, to higher education, to the workforce, to learn a trade, or to serve our country, we are first and foremost, forever and always, students. Education may begin in the classroom, but education and its effects by no means end there. The universe is a place of unknown wonder and endless possibility just waiting to be discovered and experienced. It's lessons waiting to be learned by us. We are students of experience, and everyone we meet, everything we do, will lead us closer to understanding how we will make our mark on the world. While experience may be the greatest teacher, its lessons will make the greatest impact only on those who are not only ready to receive them, but are also excited to. So go forth, go discover, go innovate, go empower, go serve, go celebrate, and go Bears.
Hi, kids. Okay. Superintendent McDavid, President Israel, members of the Board of Education, faculty and staff, friends and relatives, and most importantly, the members of the class of 2018. It is my privilege to address you at these commencement exercises this evening. Graduates, we are here tonight to honor you and all of your accomplishments. That said, this recognition also serves as acknowledgement of those folks who hold such a great place in your lives. Those who gave you life and have since sustained it. Those who love you and always will. They have taught you and instilled in you the great many wonderful qualities that you have. Things like honesty and perseverance and kindness. Traits of character that do not happen just by chance. You are the result of good people working hard to raise good people. And so graduates, what I would like you to do is please stand, turn and face your friends, your family, your relatives, your teachers, and give them a round of applause, please. Now you sit back down. Now, as a former English teacher, I like stories. And as a human being, I like stories with meaning. And as someone who has always had a somewhat short attention span, I understand that you've been sitting here for quite a while and are getting antsy. So when this story's over in about 45, no. So I'm going to tell you a tale that is short-ish and hopefully meaningful. One caveat, I'm not sure where I first heard the story, and it was quite different from my version, but just know that I'm adapting it from something that I heard once before. So picture a person walking down the street, looking at his phone like many of us do, and not paying attention to the world around him. He goes along like this for a while until he comes to a very deep hole. And as he's not paying attention, he falls in. And this hole is so deep and the walls of it so steep that he finds himself hopelessly stuck. And before you go and say he should just call someone, he broke his phone when he fell in the hole, so he can't call anybody. Not long afterwards, a politician comes along and notices him, stuck as he is in the hole. The politician exclaims, "My gosh, that's a deep hole. We need to do something about that. We'll get this fixed. I'll call the road commission. We're lucky you weren't hurt." And he goes off to politic and lobby about this massive hole. But our man is still hopelessly stuck. Next, up walks a member of the clergy. And they look in the hole and they see the man. And they say, "Oh my, how terrible. I will pray for you. And I will have my congregation send thoughts and prayers for you as well. Be at peace." And off they go with the poor man still stuck in the hole. Along comes a doctor, sees him stuck in the hole, and says, "I can help you." Writes a prescription, throws it down in the hole, and shouts, "That'll do the trick." And heads off feeling good to have done something to help the poor man. But he's still stuck in the hole. And there are others, all meaning well, who come and go without ever actually helping the poor fellow with his problem. For they are not what he needs. And finally, there comes a friend. And seeing that the man is stuck in the hole, his friend, without hesitation, jumps into the hole with him. And the man, the one who is already in the hole, looks at his friend and says, "What did you do that for? Now we're both in the hole." And his friend says, "I know, But I have been stuck down in just such a hole before, and I know that there is a way out, but only if we do it together. You see, sometimes when you are in such a place, there is no better thing than a friend. No better thing when you have fallen down into some deep, dark hole, and this is a metaphor, people, than a friend who is willing to help you, to climb down and take you by the hand, to tell you that it's going to be okay, to lead you from darkness to a better place, to let you know that there is still hope in the world at a time when there seems to be none, and that they, that friend, cares enough to help you find it. That there is someone willing to change their life by coming into whatever darkness you might find yourself in and helping you out of it. And know, too, that there will be times as you go off into this world that you will need to be that friend to someone, and that you can be. Each and every one of you has the capacity to do so, to be gentle and to be kind, to listen and to understand, to jump in and help when someone truly needs you. And I know this because I have seen you do it many times and in many ways these last 4 years, both for each other and for the people around you. And this sort of kindness, this humanity, doesn't end when you walk across this stage. In fact, it never does, and it never should. In the words of the poet Philip Larkin, we should be careful of each other. We should be kind while there is still time. I thank you and wish you all the very best. Mr. McDavid, members of the Board of Education, and all assembled, I can certify that all of these wonderful people have met and in most cases exceeded the requirements set forth to graduate by Berkley High School. So class of 2018, tonight I am honored and privileged to call you graduates. Matthew John Austin. Jalen Delena Ajene Willis. Muhammad Abdi. Renee Abuna. Besma Laith Adele. Mason Isaiah Allison. Andrew William Anniser. Mackenzie Lynn Ashburn. David Michael Austin. Christopher Saad Azar. Ryan Toby Bandoline. Natalie Paige Barber. Haley Patricia Barr. Justice Suave Bascom. Amaya Ardella Bellamy. Miles Henry Berlin. Riley Elizabeth Bialt. Troy Borman. William Paul Brett. Colin Lawrence Brickner. Brianna Michelle Broski. Christopher Michael Broski. Ryan Thomas Brown. Shayna Lauren Brown. Kadar Rizel Browning. Jasmine Elizabeth Bullock. Natalie Lillian Burt. Anna Irene Calhoun. Crystal Ashley Calloway. Hallie K. Campbell. Rachel Isabel Cantor. Catherine Coughlin Capuano. Hannah Ruth Cardew. Chloe Gray Carlson. Caitlin Nicole Carlson. Ready up. Evan Matthew Carpenter. Ready for? Chloe Fall Castle. Gabrielle Lynn Centurion. Zachary Bernard Chandler. Ready? Landon Charles Chase. Luna Chu. Brandon Isaiah Amir Coleman. Aurelius Yante Horton Coles Jr. Sean Andrew Colling. Anna Elizabeth Colvin. Matthew Ian Cook. Emma Claire Cooper. Aaron Olivia Coyne. Michael Maurice Cunez. Recorian Lavelle Cunningham. Marquel Antoine Dalton. Lillian Sarah Danaher. Lacey Michelle Davidson. Ayana Rochelle Davis. William Anthony Ronald DeBenny. Olivia Ann DePaul. Sammy Rose Dick. Peter John DiMercurio. Babacar Diop. Alana Rachel Doctoroff. Talena Janae Donaldson. Lauren Renee Duthard. Caitlin Nicole Downs. Eleanor Wave Dunkel. Sean Francis Dyer. Grace Louise Einhaus. Sloan Riley Ely. Dorothy Joanne England. Michael Sammy Ishu. Jordan Rose Esteban. Taylor Monier Favors. Gabrielle Jordan Fieber. Emily Jeanette Flannery. Danielle Michaela Flowers. Wyatt August Fons. Liam Robert Fox. Lily Shea Franklin. Sophia Mena Frigol. Emma Julianne Frontera. Andrew Michael Gobble. Pfeiffer William Gagnon. Paul Lance Gaponic Jr. Janae Nichelle Gardner. Jasmine Audrey Gardner. Matthew Joshua Gentry. Chandler Darren Gibson. Robert Leonard Gibson III. Maxwell John Good. Lillian Adele Gordon. Patrice Renee Gordon. Austin Graves. Lauren Elizabeth Graziani. Noah Robert Greer. Liam Theodore Gregorio. Amelia Brenda Gross.
Marie, right?
Lily Marie Gross. Ruth Hannah Grossbach. Naomi Rachel Grossbach. Quinn Scarlett Guthrie. Harriet Prue Hall. Chloe Rose Halprin. Braden Sears Hamilton. Justin Rondell Harris. Connor Anthony Harris. Autumn Delana Hauser.
Oh, slow down there, Eddie.
Edgar Ray Hauser II. Reginald David Hawkins II.
Go that way.
Scott Robert Haring. Adam Michael Healy. Kwame Sekou Maloney Henry. Abby King Harrington. Nathan Eli Herskovitz. Robert Allen Hurstman. Madison Elise Hicks. Aaron Verschel High. Hunter Christian Hockridge. Helen Elizabeth Hoffman. Jason Allen Holloway. Fiona Constance Hopeby. Sarah Catherine House. Jada Marie Hubble. Abigail Frances Hurley. John Wesley Hutcherson IV. Spencer Riley Inman. Douglas Bernard Jackson III. Hannah Paige Jacobs. Joshua Murphy James. Savannah Nicole Marie Jefferson. Amar Sherwin Johnson. Cameron Johnson. LaJoy Kendall Jones. Anthony Jones. Avery Annalise Justice. McGuire Jane Casey. Addison Diana Kaiser. Anna Francesca Carly. Zachary Daniel Kempner. Brett Michael Kirby. Camden Noack King. Haley Ada Kinney. Noah Sloan Clyde.
You ready?
Thomas Sidney Klein. Natalie Mae Nisley. Joseph Randolph Cook. Arena Korakova. Jonathan Yalbraku Kwachi. Max Charlie Quarterwitz. Nathan Gabriel Lafamboise. Madison Marie Lamb. Eric Michael Landgraf. Anthony Ray Lane. Kyle Scott LaRiviere. Kara Haley Lash. Robin Victoria Lee. Grace Madeline Leonard. Ariana Bella Lerner. Melanie Renee Levy. Yael Noah Levy. Brianna Claire Lewis.
They let you in, huh?
Ella Jean Lipman. David Alfonso Long III.
Ready, Lemon?
Emily Elizabeth Lonsky. Catherine Hannah Lubinecki. Domenico Antonio Luca. Andrea Luna. Brendan Kelly Lynch. Hannah Claire Lyons. Ethan David McFarlane. Riley Rebecca McInhawley. Heather Lynn McCumber. Angel Kiera Maddox. Isabella Sophia Marcioni. Alex Weston Marshner. Michael William Martin. Sophia Rose Mason. Jace Matthews. Isabella Bela Leah Mavishev. Cameron Ariana McCrary. Morgan Elise McGoy. Gregory Benjamin McGee. Tristan Joel McGibbon. Edwin Carl Johann Meltz. Alec Declan Milanowski. Chloe Danielle Miller. Cassidy Jenna Molander. Cameron Johnny Monroe. Chloe Bless Moore. Brandon Morrison Jr. Brianna Morrison. Isabel Chinchu Moss. Shinshang George Moss. Joshua Aaron Mosell. Hannah Rose Mulheron. Sean Thomas Mullane. Bailey Elizabeth Myers. Abigail Brayton Nash. Devin Micah Tatuo Nicholson Harris.
Still no middle name, right?
Zachary Nikolai. Bolanle Opinyemi Uluwole.
Ready?
John Paul Perot. Michael Robert McCullough Perryman. Deja Lee Marie Pickens. Brittany Rachel Pickman. Isabella May Pierce. Kira Dawson Pompos. Danielle Esther Portal. Megan Lee Quinlan. Carissa Nalini Ramsarat. William Thomas Rayon. Thomas William Rennie. Alexandra Ross Rapinski. Stephanie Nora Rippey. Isabella Anna Romano. David Hunter Rombach.
What did you do to my collar?
Natalie Sarah Rosenblatt. Maya Angelique Ross. Taylor Renee Rucker. Selena Miriam Salon. Santeo Chachipili Sanchez. Emily Caroline Sanders. Bailey Elise Saris. Joseph Alexander Scarcello. Andrew Todd Schildkraut. Jackson Paul Shadowski. Dax Loki Schoaf. Beth Angela Ruth Schulman. Sarah Grace Schwanke. Kelly Elizabeth Siemens. Samantha Rose Selleck. Jacob Weiss Sirwa. Ava Christine Shannon. Melanie Janae Shaw. Christopher James Brendan Shelley. Christian Matthew Sievers. Jessica Rose Simmons. Alexandria Renee Simpkins. Drew Sharon Tenise Simpson. Emily Catherine Sines. Daniel Isaac Sklar. Adam Charles Skoglin. Benjamin Davis Slutsky. Javay Louise Smith.
How are you? You ready to go? All right.
Malik Andre Smith. Samantha Janine Smith. Scott Christopher Smith. James Anthony Smike. Daniel Joseph Spear. Tyler Allen Spencer. Christopher James Squires. Emma Josephine Stahl. Luis David Stibitz Barone. Samuel Harrison Stone. Carlin Louise Stone. Leia Michelle Sugarman.
Sylvester.
Skaya Berlin Sylvester. Hayden Elizabeth Zuber. Jacob Donald Teradonia. Emma Rose Tarnopol.
You ready, Carson?
Carson Emery Teicher. Alexa Christine Thibodeau. Jake Jeffrey Thiel. Hannah Loren Thomas. Graham Scott Thompson. Natalia Grace Tavares. William James Townsend. John Michael Treppa. Ruslan Uvarov. Tyler Andrew Veltri. Alexandra Paige Veltri. Amy Rochelle Vodopianov. Tyler James Voles. Anthony Watson. Henry Joseph Weiss.
Wellamero.
Nicholas Tyler Wellamero. Jack Taylor Welsh. Megan Ann West. Timon Daniel Winham. Justin Rakis Willie Patrick White.
Ready, Horizon?
Horizon Hyacinth Will. Alicia Ann Wills. Selena Renee Wilson. Olivia Louise Wilson. Henry Jonathan Winsner. Sari Nicole Wise. Joseph Levi Wolberg. Caitlin Isabel Wolberg. Ari Samuel Wolfson. Harrison James Wyrett. Miles Jacob Young. Corey Ethan Zimmerman. Alyssa Marie Zeno. Lucas Stephen Zolman.
Does this go back to the middle? You want this?
Parents and guests, please remain seated until the graduates have exited the pavilion. Class of 2018, please stand. Please switch your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations, fellow alumni of Berkley High School.